You want to pay me to tell you about my son? Is that it? You can buy my body, Mr. Shelby, but my son is not for sale. Get out of here. Get the fuck out!
I'll see you again, asshole.
Lieutenant Blake, I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning. They told me you'd be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Harry, comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death.
You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor.
Do you think it's gonna take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. Oh, cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain. Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. I just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get them well together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press are all over us. This Origami Killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
No, of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Well, I hope you're better at profiling than at tying knots. Oh, forget it, I'll manage. Oh, go see Charlie and she'll show you to your office. Yeah, check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
Wasteland in the East End at about 6:30 a.m., 5 days after he was reported missing. An autopsy will be conducted tomorrow to determine the exact cause of death, but going from first indications, it would seem that he drowned. The state in which the body was found suggests the methodology of the Origami Killer. The investigation should confirm this in the coming days. The police are continuing to work around the clock to find the murderer as quickly as possible. I'll field some questions. Yes.
You said the methodology indicated another victim for the Origami Killer. Can you be more specific?
An origami figure was found in the victim's hand, and an orchid was placed on his chest. His face was covered with mud, but there were no visible traces of violence to the body.
The Zodiac Killer was never identified. Perhaps the Origami Killer will never be found either.
I don't think there's much chance of that. For the moment, the killer may think he's invulnerable, but in the end, he'll make a mistake and we'll be there to arrest him. Yes?
Did the killer leave any written evidence? Perhaps a ransom note explaining his actions? Or anything like that?
No. He has not made contact in any way, and we have only the murders to help us understand his motives. Yes. What's the question?
Some people are saying that the police were slow to take an interest in these murders because the victims lived in poorer parts of the city. What do you say to that?
That's absurd. The police make no distinctions between victims based on their social class. It is true that the Origami Killer seems to choose his victims from the more impoverished parts of town. The higher crime rate in these areas makes the investigation more difficult. Time for a couple more. Yes.
There are rumors that the FBI has sent a profiler to help with the investigation. Is that true?
You seem to be well informed. Yes, we asked the FBI to send us a profiler to help us with this investigation. We were planning to announce this in the next few days, but it seems that won't be necessary.
According to certain sources, the town hall's been applying pressure to avoid any mention of a serial killer in order not to have an adverse effect on the mayor's election campaign. Do you have anything to say about that?
Pure speculation. At no time has the mayor been involved in this investigation, except to support the efforts of the police force, of course. Thank you for your cooperation.
One question, please, sir. One last question.
Captain Perry, one more question, please.
I'm ready to start. Maybe we should kick off by talking about the case?
I have some work to finish here. Let's talk about that later, if you don't mind.
Okay. No problem. Just let me know when you're available. Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Congratulate Larry on my behalf.
I'll be sure to do that, sir.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work. Step one, change the office. Thank you. 8 victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. Always the same ritual, an origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned, over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on. The killer is white, age between 30 and 45. He is intelligent, calm, and determined. An organized type. He has a car. He's probably employed, but his work allows him free time. There is always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall. The killer has a large comfort zone. He gained confidence rapidly and moved away from his base. This won't make the geoprofiling any easier. Killer's car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83. No prints or specific clues. Nothing much to go on. Common species. That doesn't help much. The orchid is a common species. It can be found at any flower shop. Just one origami store in town. Here we go again. I better go wash my face. I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. It's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
Is everything all right, Shaun?
No one. No one would see.
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marsh. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Shaun. We played together for a while, and then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses, and when I turned back, Shaun had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Mars. Every detail can be important.
It must have been about... ...5:30, I think. I'm not really sure.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat. A black coat. And a pair of pants. Beige pants.
How could Shaun have disappeared without you even noticing? Weren't you right by the carousel?
I went for a short walk around the park, just for a few minutes. When I got back, the carousel had stopped, and Shaun wasn't there.
You say you took your son to the park after school, but you didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
I searched the whole neighborhood for him. I thought he couldn't have gone far.
Did Shaun have any particular difficulties, Mr. Mars? Anything that might have caused him to run away?
No, I don't think so.
Everything okay at school? Any particular problems between you and your wife?
No, nothing in particular.
All right, that's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Shaun overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Do you think the Origami Killer...
Listen, your son's probably just run off and he'll turn up in a couple hours.
But what if it is the Origami Killer?
Well, then we have about 4 days to find him alive.
Find something?
No, nothing yet, but they're gonna keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the Origami Killer?
It's still too early to say, but it is a possibility.
Shaun like that. You should never have taken your eyes off him. I mean, for God's sake, how hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan? Why? Wasn't it enough losing Jason? I'm sorry. It's not what I meant to say.
Evening.
Good evening to you, sir.
Can I help you, sir?
Well, I hope so. My name's Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
My son is dead, Mr. Shelby. I have nothing more to say.
I also lost someone I loved. I know what you're feeling.
Then you will understand that I do not wish to talk about it.
You may know something that could help save other people's lives.
I was unable to save the life of my own son. I do not see how I could save the lives of other people.
Oh, do you sell inhalers? I'm all out, and at least I won't go away completely empty-handed.
In the back of this door, to the right.
Thanks.
Good evening, sir. Are you looking for something in particular?
Give me what you got in the registry. Don't fucking try anything. Open the register, you dumb fuck! Put the money on the counter! Shit, are you deaf or what? Are you gonna open that fucking register or not?
No, sir. You do not have the right to steal that money from me. I have worked very hard to earn it. You cannot have it.
What did you say? You're out of your fucking mind, man! You don't get it, do you? I'm gonna put a fucking bullet right between your eyes if you don't do what I say now!
Shall not be robbing.
Hey, you! Come here! I said come here now! Don't move! Hands up! Put your fucking hands up or I'll shoot!
Look, it's not worth it. Put the gun down and just walk away.
You giving me advice? I'll give you some fucking advice.
Don't panic. Let's just stay calm. Nobody here wants to hurt you. We're all just gonna be cool and everything will be all right.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm cool, man. Everything's gonna be all fucking right.
You don't really want to shoot anybody, do you? I'm sure we can find a way out of this mess, right? Now, I want you to put the gun back in your pocket and quietly walk out of the store. My friend and I will forget about what just happened, and you'll have earned a second chance not to fuck up your life. What do you say?
Nice try. For a second there, you almost had me believing all your shit. And now...
Thousand thank you, sir. I don't know what would have happened if you had not been here.
At least I didn't come by for nothing. Have a nice day.
When my boy, Reza, disappeared, I received a letter with a locker ticket inside. Inside the locker, I found this box. I do not understand what it means, but I think it must be a sort of message from the man who took my son from me.
Can I?
Please, take the box if it can be of any use to you at all. It did not help me to save Reza, but maybe it will help you find the other little boy. Mr. Shelby.
I was beginning to think that there was no good to be found in this place. But I can see now that I was wrong.
There's someone here. There's someone in the apartment. The phone on the desk. I could call for help. The front door. It's the only way out. If I can reach it, I still have a chance.
When the parents came home from church, all their children were gone. They searched and called for them, they cried and begged, but it was all to no avail. The children have never been seen again. I have to get out of here and find out what this ticket is about.
Gonna have to make it through the crowd. I can't take crowds. Just can't handle it. I can't make it. Too many people. Too many people.
Line 18, box number 3. Line 18, box number 3.
Shaun.
Where are you? I'm so cold. Dad. Dad.